there, boys and girls. Now, there's a little bit of fan noise in the background, and I'm going to apologize for that, but I live in Texas. Alexa, what is the temperature outside today?
Right now, it's 106 degrees Fahrenheit. Tonight, expect a low of 76 degrees.
106 degrees Fahrenheit. For you people across...
106 degrees Fahrenheit is about 41.11 degrees Celsius.
I was just going to say it's about 41 degrees Celsius, but thank you.
I don't know that.
Hush. So, 41 degrees Celsius, 106 degrees Fahrenheit. I think you'll pardon me for the fan. But anyway... is done. Well, it'll never be done. I'll always be adding little things to it and making it do new things. But the mill has been fixed. Got new PVC on the surface. This is already a Delrin plastic, so this is all waterproof now, which means eventually I'll probably put in a mist cooling system. As you can see, I've added some lighting underneath of here, which is really handy. So, in the grand scheme of things, that is what was burnt out. This is the main board, which connects to this hand controller. Now, I never liked this hand controller. 256 meg max. So it had a little USB thing on here, and you could only use up to a 256 megabyte thumb drive. How many of them do you see anymore, right? So you needed a special thumb drive, and the only thing this could do would be jog forward and back, start and go, basically. It didn't really have a lot of controls. Wait till you see what I've got it doing now. This is a magnetic sensor, and this is a little piece of metal that sticks up. And when this piece of metal comes in front of this sensor, that tells it it is at the home position, okay? That's the Z-axis. This is the X-axis, and you see it's got one too. The reason it's a different color is you can have them either be normally closed or normally open. The one here was broken. I had one of these in there, so I replaced it with this type and just told the system, hey, this one's different than the rest. And then over here is the one for the Y-axis. And this one will trigger when this bearing crosses over it. And I'll show you that in just a bit. One of the things the Laguna never had before was a work light like this. And I really like it because there's some shadows and stuff in here, and I'm doing video, and you can see how lovely it is. It's well lit, so when I want to show you what a project I'm working on, you'll be able to see it nice and clear. So I'm very excited about that. Also, something that Laguna never had, the big red button. If I'm sitting up here and that big scary machine is moving fast and I see it's going to do something dangerous, now I can hit the big red button and that'll be it. It'll stop. So let's take a look at that. This is the 220 volts power. We turn that on, and that clunk that you heard was all of these stepper motors locking in place. Now, you see that the light here is red. That tells me that the emergency stop is triggered. So this isn't gonna start up on me. This isn't gonna go anywhere, and I can safely come in here and work on things and fix a problem, which is very, very handy. All right, so when I activate the machine, the first thing you'll notice is the light turns to white. That tells me that it's safe to proceed. Now what I'll do is I'll tell it to home all. And you'll see when that little piece of metal comes over here. See? Now it'll come down this way until it hits this one. And when it comes all the way and that bearing crosses over that, So this is what's called the machine home position. It's right here. And what that means is the machine knows its position. So I can move it anywhere on the table now and specify a work position, and it knows how to get there. The cool thing is, if I tell this thing to move or do something, so say I tell it to go and move to the storage position, and something happens, when I hit that button, it stops cold. And it will not go anywhere. So that can prevent people from getting hurt, prevent things from getting damaged. And I don't know why the Laguna never had a big red button on it like that. But I think it's very important. I like my big red button. And you see it turns off. And you can see when I come up here and reactivate the machine, that comes back on and my light comes back on here. Now if I do a stop at a high speed like that, there's a chance it could lose its homing position. But it's not a super bad thing. All I do is come in here and tell it to home all. And then it's going to ask me, hey, you already did it. You want to do it again? Yep, I do. And it will go through the process again. And life is good, and it's back to where it was. So, let me show you what that little puck is for. Let's say that this was some piece of plastic that I was going to machine, right? And I tell this thing to come over to the home position. You know, say I was working over here. And you notice there's a little bit of a gap there between the part and the piece. Now, I can sit there, and I can try to guess where that is, you know, and stuff like that. But if I make a mistake, I can have this piece come down and gouge a hole into it. So what I can do instead is raise it up a little bit, take this puck and set it in here like this, right? And I'll hold that in place. And then I can hit the probe button. And see, it will touch that, and now it knows exactly what that height is. And the cool thing about it is I can have this, you know, in some other part of the table. And when I tell it to go home now, it will come down exactly to the surface. Look at that. And it's not scratching it. It's right at the surface. And I can begin my job. And I can find that same point every single time. So if I wanted to make 100 of these and I had a little jig set up to hold it in place, I could engrave it, have it get out of the way, and make another one just fine, and I can do it all day long. Okay, so I usually do not like videoing a screen, but unfortunately the computer has enough power to run the machine, but if I try to do a screen capture too, it just doesn't want to play too nice, so we'll have to do it this way. But I just wanted to show you some of the different things on the screen. You already saw the home button, and when I hit it, it asked me if I want to do it again. And it will go through the process of finding all of the magnetic switches. And then it's at its home position, okay? Now, what I did was, I know that I programmed this for a certain length and a certain width and a certain height. So I said, you know what, if I'm moving something, I don't want to have this blade sitting right here. If I go to reach for something, I could scratch my hand on it. I could cut myself. It would be nice if I can make this thing go away. So what I did was, if you'll notice right here, there's a move to storage. And when I hit that button, it quickly moves away to the other side of the machine. Now I can come over here and I can adjust things and clamp parts down and do all that kind of stuff without worry about getting hurt. So that's a really cool function. Now over here I've got the movement switches for the different axes, and I can bring it out here like this. And I'll bring this close so that you can see it. This is the spindle. This spindle is a 2,500 watt spindle, air-cooled. That is a lot of power, much more than the old one had. Well, I think so. It might have been the same, actually. But it's got a bigger collet, and it can take some massive bits. So what I found out was a lot of them use what's called PWM. It's a series of pulses that run the speed of it. But when they set up Laguna, they didn't do that. They had 4 bits. And so this one by itself was 10,000 RPM. This one by itself was 20,000. If you did both of them, 15,000. If you did both of them, it did 20,000. And then if you kicked in this bit, it did 25. And by doing other bits, you could get higher speeds, but I don't ever want to run it faster than that. So I made these buttons over here, see? And if I hit the 10K, you'll see it runs at 10K, and I have an indicator that tells me the spindle's on, and the first bit is on. If I hit 15, see, it goes up to 15,000 RPM, right? 20,000. Now you see that the low and the higher, the low and the medium are running. And then I can go to 25,000, and then that's the super high, and then I have off. So that gives me some really good control over what this can do. Now, I'm not really going to engrave something today. We'll do another video on that. I'll do a project and we'll have a really cool thing to show you. But for right now, if I click on file and I open a recent file, I've got my Askjerry. Now you see this mark right here? That means that it's off the edge of the machine. If I take a look at this, you can see that the machine can't get to where it needs to be. And if I try to tell it to run, it's going to say, hey, no, you can't do that. So what I have to do is I have to set a new home position. So in this case, I can tell it to go to the safe home, which is over here. And then I can tell this thing, all right, you're there, but I want you to move, let's say, 200 millimeters. So I can say G0, which is move quickly, X200. And it'll move over to here. So then I can say set that as the new home. All right. So now when I do that and I reload this, you see how it moved over? And if we look at it in 3D space, you see it's in the middle of the machine more, and it's not going to get into the edge. This is something that the original Laguna simply could not do. It just didn't have the capability to do that. So I think this is a really cool feature. And then if I want to run, I would put the bit in there, lock it down, and just hit the run button. Starts up the spindle. And you can see it's got a little, I got to make a better mount for this thing because it wants to wobble. The machine's got so much power, it's moving this whole 200-pound machine. And then when it's finished, it'll shut down and go back to the home position, and it's ready to do another part. So all of that is working really, really well right now. I've got my indicators, which if you saw my other video, I based them on the Apollo buttons. I found an Apollo panel on the internet, got the photograph of it, and used it as my backgrounds for my images. And I've got spare things, which will be for some new features coming down later. And when I get ready to put this thing away, all I do is move it to the storage position. And then I come over here and I can turn it off. Or I can hit the emergency button. Boom. Got my E-stop. Everything's cool. Now I can just take this and I can close this out. And then I can go in here and I can shut it down and it'll be ready for the next time I want to use it. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned. I've got new stuff coming up and we'll see what kind of other things we can get into.